Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be converting a polar point to a Cartesian point. The problem that we have is the polar point 1, pi over 4, and we're going to take that and we're going to convert it to Cartesian coordinates. So with this problem and any problem in which you're converting polar coordinates to Cartesian coordinates, you're going to be using these two formulas here. X equals r cosine of theta and y equals r sine of theta. Now, whenever you're converting coordinates from polar to Cartesian, what you need to remember is that the polar coordinates that you're given here, 1, pi over 4, are representing r, theta. So what that means is that we're going to be plugging in 1 for r here and here, and pi over 4 for theta here and here. So that's all we're going to do. We're going to plug in those two points, 1 for r and pi over 4 for theta, into our two formulas, x equals r cosine of theta and y equals r sine of theta. So those are the two equations that we're going to be working with. And the next thing we do, once we've got these written down here, is identify the point pi over 4 on the unit circle, which we've got up here. So we look on the unit circle and we're looking for pi over 4 here, because we've got pi over 4 in both of our equations. So we look on the unit circle and we see that it's this point here, pi over 4. Now when you're working with the unit circle, the thing that you need to remember is that these Cartesian coordinates here along the outside of the circle, the x term, in this case here, the square root of 2 over 2, it is representing cosine. So when we are looking for cosine of pi over 4, we find the angle pi over 4, and then we look at the x term here in the Cartesian coordinate. So in this case, the square root of 2 over 2. Now when we're trying to find sine of pi over 4, again, we look for the angle pi over 4. So here we have pi over 4. And then we're looking for the y coordinate at that point, which again is the square root of 2 over 2. So that tells us that we have x equals the square root of 2 over 2 and y equals the square root of 2 over 2 as well, because this cosine of pi over 4 gets replaced with this x coordinate here, square root of 2 over 2, and sine of pi over 4 here gets replaced with this y term here, the square root of 2 over 2. So we take that, we now take this x and y coordinate and put those together to come up with our Cartesian coordinates, and that's our final answer here. We've converted the polar coordinates, 1, pi over 4, into Cartesian coordinates, the square root of 2 over 2, the square root of 2 over 2. So I hope that helped, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!